And welcome back, guys. This is Ibrahim Quraishi here, and we are going to do a quick session only focusing on DRS. The previous session we went a little bit about DRS, and I did demo on CentOS installation as well. But I just thought I have missed certain topics, and I need to differentiate between HA and DRS. So here it goes. So what basically DRS is distributed resource scheduler, which basically balances your workload on the virtual estate. So now VMware has come up with storage DRS as well. So you can have DRS running on your compute side and also the storage side. Now in comparison with HA is high availability for making sure your VM comes up when you have a host failures. But DRS is to balance the cluster in a fashion where you don't have a VM struggling or stressing out CPU on one host and making the other VMs struggle as well. So let's get this is a really brilliant feature of VMware. I love it, and this is why I think VMware administrator should be knowing all these features, because it's a fully automated environment. As a VMware administrator, I don't need to worry about my workload. They keep balancing and moving around as and where they find a best fit for the VM. In the newer versions of DRS, they are going to use different sort of metrics as well. Before, it was always about CPU and memory, but now the metrics which they have introduced is network metrics as well, which basically will see a host if it is having too much network workload, then that VMs can move to other hosts where there's not a lot of network utilization, which is really awesome, because so far we never had anything related to networks. We only had compute and storage, so which is exciting to see. So so before I forget, let's remind you, thanks a lot for your comment and feedback. Especially I get a lot of comment back from CentOS group in on Facebook and VMware groups on Facebook, along with LinkedIn, where I post mostly. So thanks a lot, guys, and I love it. Don't forget to subscribe and share the channel as much as you can. So let's get started. So again, what is DRS? We covered that topic. The prerequisite of DRS, again, we are going to cover that. So as we know, we need to have at least two hosts for DRS to work, and the DRS compute DRS basically works with CPU and memory. So all the VMs, if you have a VM running, so it is basically actually the VM is using the memory and CPU of that particular host. When it needs to migrate to a different host, it copies all the bytes from the memory and the CPU instructions to the other host. As soon as that data is copied, the VM starts running on the other host. But this, you might remember, this is vMotion really. So that's all it is leveraging. DRS basically leverages the existing vMotion network and the vMotion capabilities of VMware to move things around, to balance things out. So VMware is, I think it's like an orange. It has so many pieces around it, and it uses each and every feature when you need it. So obviously, vMotion being one of it. Again, we discussed a little bit about storage DRS already. This is especially useful when you have a VM which is on a storage and that's growing and growing, and eventually it figures that it is hitting the threshold of 20% limit. Then it starts migrating the VMs to other storage data stores, which are free. Maybe they are having, 40% free. So it will try and move it there. So it will balance it out before you even need to get involved in it. So that's the beauty of storage DRS, which is, again, gives that cushion to VMware administrators so that you can have a little bit peaceful sleeps at night, So let's look at the scenario which we have in my lab at the moment. So as we all know, we have a demo cluster. I have done some screenshots for you. So on this demo cluster, this the first host which we have is running 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 VMs, and the memory utilization is nearly around a gig on this particular host. Don't forget, in my lab, all these, well, these two hosts are virtual machines anyway, so it's a nested lab, nested ESX host environment. Underneath, we are using our famous, as I said, Dell Optiplex 7010. So let's not get into that. Let's focus here. So this is the first host. What about the second one, which is this one? So if I click, so this is the second one, and it's having a lot of capacity free. Oh, I should have better formatted this. I could potentially do it now. Okay, let's cancel that. And so as you can see, we have 3 gig remaining here, and we have over in the previous slide, we have around only 1 gig here. So this host clearly is struggling, and I don't have HA enabled at this point. So I'm excuse me. So as I was saying, I'm going to enable HA for this demo. It has only two, this particular host has only two VMs, and it has, like I said, 3 gig remaining. So to enable HA, what do we need to do? We need to go to right click cluster settings, and we need to enable turn on vSphere HA. That's all you need to do. And then you do have some more options. You have three options in HA. With the DRS automation, you have, first one is manual, and the second one is partially automated. The third one is what I like, the fully automated one. And even in fully automated, there are 5 steps. So let's dive into that quickly. So as I said, manual, partially automated, and fully automated. So when I say manual, there's no DRS happening. DRS gives you suggestions and recommendations. So as I suggest, a vCenter server will suggest migration recommendation for virtual machine. In partially automated, virtual machine will be automatically placed on the host at power on the vCenter. So it will suggest us, and it will automatically place it at the time of power on. It will place it on the right right location where it thinks it best fits the memory and CPU requirement. If it is fully automated, we have three, in this we have this slider, which is conservative and aggressive. So if we slide it all the way to the right, which is aggressive, it basically will balance the cluster. And even with a slight change or improvement, the cluster starts to rebalance everything. So if it picks up a VM, starts using more CPU and memory, it tries to push it to another host maybe, which is not very much utilized. And so basically, even a slight change will basically trigger a vMotion perhaps. So with the new features I wanted to discuss is predictive DRS. So predictive DRS works in conjunction with VROps, which I have got running in my environment, VROps 7, and at some point we'll have a look at VROps as well. But this basically uses the forecasting feature, the forecasting metrics of VROps, and it predicts where at peak times what the VMs do, and based on that it will allow DRS to do predictive DRS, which is a cool feature really. So as I said, VMware and the Orange, which I was resembling, so it has so many tools which are coming around, you know, complementing each another product, which is what we love, which it basically integrates very seamlessly with products like VROps. We have another product called Orchestration VRO, which works very nicely. We have products like VRA, which are automation, which works very nicely with vCenter and everything around it. So it's a lot there, guys. We are just getting started, I'm telling you. This is just the tip of the iceberg. Okay, let's dive into it. Okay, so this is something I want to discuss later after our demo, because I wanted to show when things migrate, to check whether it was an automated or a manual one. You can select a VM and click on monitor, and then click on add task and events, and then select migrate virtual machine, the first event. Anything which says migrate virtual machine, that's automatically done by the DRS. So you can see here says DRS migration photon 1, that's the name of the machine. So that's DRS migrating it. So let's look at the demo now. I'm going to go back to my vCenter server, which is here. Right click on the cluster as we have gone through in the slides, and then usually we need to go at settings again, but we are already on the configuration and we have selected vSphere DRS. So edit settings again, and then you can see vSphere DRS is turned off at the moment. So I'm going to enable it, and then we are going to open this and make sure it's fully automated, which it says here, and then we turn it to aggressive. Now, just before I do that, just to prove my point, this host here has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which I have the screenshot about, and this has only 2. And the resources here is 3 gig free, and this host here is 1 gig pretty much free, with 5 VMs running on it. So let's go back again, right click, settings, and then what we do is edit, and then enable DRS, like this, and we have got fully automated selected, and the slider is all the way up, which is good. Click OK. So let's pull this up so that we can see the activities happening. It will be fun as well. Let's select this host so that we can see VMs jumping down on this host. So we have to give it a minute or so for it to recognize that DRS is enabled, and hopefully we should start seeing some activities very soon. So if I click on cluster, there's another thing I needed to show you. So if I click on DRS, the last VM sitting on here, let's see what it does. Migrate, next. So here we are going to have a cluster which is just a host which is just empty, and then the other one running 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 VMs. These two are centers, by the way, 2 gig each. So there's 2 gig there. Used memory. Yeah, so that's 1.5 gig used there. Quite tempted to do something else now. Clone. And then clone it. On here, so we can stress. So that's a cloning operation going on at the moment. The background that doesn't cause any impact really. And there you go, we are seeing all those machines jumping again, so they will be jumping here. So it just needs a trigger, because obviously it won't move even though it is imbalanced. As long as there is enough capacity for, or as long as it's scoping up well, then it doesn't move those VMs around. And as soon as it thinks that, okay, even though it has less than 1 gig of like 1 gig remaining and the other one has 6 gig, if they are working okay, they are not making noise, then it doesn't move them. As soon as it picks up that the VM is, I think they have moved here, but we can't see because it's the flash which is not working. Let's refresh this. Yeah, can you see that? These two has back come back here. And what else is, so that's the cloning operation which is happening in the background, which is fine. So this is using 800 MB, this is 200 MB. So it has potentially, as you saw, pushed two VMs back. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 VMs here again, as it was, and these two VMs are here. So I disabled the DRS just for the purpose of demo. When I was moving them, I didn't want them to come back. That's why I did that. Hope you understand that. But yeah, what we could do is click on, okay, let's click on CentOS, this machine, and go to task and event and see over here. So virtual machine, and if you scroll down, there you go, at 12:22 a.m. Is that right? Yeah. So the second today, which is Wednesday now, DRS migration CentOS from 3 to 4. Okay. And then if we select Photon as well, which happened at the pretty much the same time, yeah, literally the same timestamp, and migrated from there to there. And this was a migration which we did manually. So Photon host migrate off to host 3 in London. Hot migration, which means while it is running, while the VM is running. So that's something which we did a couple of minutes before. So that's about it, guys. Hope you liked it. It did take a little bit of while for them, for the host to start pushing things around with DRS. But as I said, if the host is not recognizing that any of the VM are struggling, and if it has enough capacity, then it doesn't move. But in some occasions, if the VM are busy, it's a peak day time, if they are working a lot, then for a slight change, it start moving the workload. So hope you enjoyed the session. Let's quickly go back to the presentation. So again, you saw how we can check whether it was a DRS migration or a manual migration. Always remember, if you have a, you if you have vMotion and you have an issue and you want to figure out whether it was manually done or DRS did it, you can always select the VM, go to monitor, go to task, and then select the task one by one and go through them. So this one, first one, says DRS migration, which is basically done by the system. So VMware picked up that it needs to go to a better host, which can basically give it better performance. That's about it for the demo, guys. Thanks for watching. Reach out to me on Twitter if you have any questions. As always, follow my blog agileops.co.uk. And the question of the day: does DRS need shared storage to work? Yes or no? Please leave comments below and let me know. Don't forget to subscribe. Enjoy watching and keep sharing, guys. Cheers. Bye.